Two autonomous surface vessels from the U.S. Navy have successfully reached Japan. Mariner and Ranger, the unmanned vessels, arrived at Yokosuka, which is the base of the U.S. 7th Fleet. This marks the culmination of a long-range deployment that commenced last month from their home port just north of Los Angeles. Notably, this historic Pacific crossing by the U.S. Navy's unmanned ships was conducted with a minimal crew on board, as these vessels are still test platforms. Prior to their arrival in Yokosuka, the two USVs took part in training exercises in the Pacific region, contributing to the enhancement of maritime domain awareness for the Carl Vinson Carrier Strike Group. In this video, Defense Updates reports on U.S. Navy unmanned vessels reaching Japan. Let's get into the details. Mariner and Ranger are part of a fleet consisting of five prototyped unmanned surface vessels within the U.S. Navy's Unmanned Surface Vessel Division 1. They are termed as LUSV, or Large Unmanned Surface Vessels. These USVs have a wide range of capabilities, encompassing surface and subsurface combat, surveillance, reconnaissance, command and control, as well as intelligence gathering. The primary objective behind these prototypes is to expedite the deployment of proficient and dependable unmanned systems for remote, semi-autonomous, or fully autonomous operations within the broader naval fleet, with the aim of determining their optimal utilization. The Mariner and Ranger are the direct result of the Strategic Capabilities Office's Ghost Fleet Overlord program. Viewers may note that Ranger made an appearance at the 2022 Rim of the Pacific exercise. The main purpose of these prototypes is to help the Navy accelerate the delivery of capable and reliable unmanned systems that can be operated remotely, semi or fully autonomously, by figuring out how to best use them within the broader fleet. A large fleet of traditional manned ships is costly to operate and maintain. It's the need of the hour that few tasks are shifted to unmanned platforms. This also fits in the larger concept of having a more distributed and flexible fleet. U.S. Navy envisions a ghost fleet consisting of large unmanned surface vehicles, LUSVs, medium unmanned surface vehicles, MUSVs, and extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles, XLUUVs. The vessels will be low-cost, high-endurance, and modular, that is, they'll be reconfigurable vessels and will be equipped according to mission requirements. The U.S. Navy plans to acquire two LUSVs per year from fiscal year 2022 through fiscal year 2024. These are between 200 feet to 300 feet in length and have a displacement of about 2,000 tons when fully loaded, making the LUSV the largest unmanned ship to date. They would not just be transport and surveillance components for the U.S. Navy, but could be used as offensive platforms in the future. For example, in 2021, Ranger was used to launch an SM-6 missile from an on-deck launcher, with control exercised by personnel located on a separate ship. Each LUSV can be armed with a vertical launch system with 16 to 32 missile launching tubes. So technically, these vessels could pack a lot of punch. The U.S. Navy has a plan for about 40% of its fleet to be comprised of unmanned systems by the middle of this century. John Bradford, a naval expert and former country director for Japan at the Office of the U.S. Defense Secretary, said, "These will be able to do almost everything that current generation manned vessels do, but at a lower cost. They could scout dangerously close to enemy formations, carry forces and equipment through a blockade, or serve as remote firing batteries." Rear Admiral Blake Converse, Deputy Commander of the U.S. Pacific Fleet, described unmanned and autonomous technologies as K key to growing our distributed maritime operations framework. By proliferating our presence in the Pacific and increasing the fleet's situational awareness and lethality, we give ourselves more options to make better decisions at all levels of leadership, the Admiral added. It's evident that the U.S. Navy is looking at unmanned surface vessels as a force multiplier, and sending these to Japan makes a lot of sense.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.